Hello everybody and welcome to Willa Dean's Kitchen. Today's recipe is going to be baked honey mustard chicken. So what we have here is we have some boneless, skinless chicken thighs. I have some salt and pepper on them and a little bit of garlic. So they've just been seasoned lightly and they're going to be ready to go into the oven once we get our sauce prepared. So for our honey mustard sauce, we have honey. Have a half a cup of honey. We have about a half a cup of yellow mustard. And we have some seasonings here. We have some garlic powder, paprika, black pepper, and dried oregano. And it's a quarter teaspoon of each of those spices. We have 2 tablespoons of butter. And we have maybe a half a teaspoon, maybe a little bit more of Worcestershire sauce in here. So we have the sauce in this little bowl. I don't know if you can see that, but it's in there. And we're gonna put a dash, maybe a teaspoon of Dijon mustard in here, the Grey Poupon. And then we have some chili garlic sauce here that we're gonna put maybe a teaspoon or so of this in there to give it some spice and some kick. So what I'm gonna do next is I'm gonna get the burner out and I'm gonna get the sauce mixed up. All right, we have our pot is on the burner. So we're gonna start putting our ingredients in. So the first ingredient we're going to place in here is the butter. So we got 2 tablespoons of butter there. We're gonna let that go in and start melting. It's going to melt down here, and then we're going to add our honey to this as well. So we have about a half a cup of pure honey made by the bees, all natural. So this honey is raw honey, hasn't been filtered or anything, so it's very flavorful. Then next we're going to add our mustard to the pot as well. We have some yellow mustard. This is just your standard yellow mustard. Nothing fancy here. You can get this in any market, supermarket store. We're going to go ahead and put in our dry spices here. The garlic, the paprika, the black pepper, and the oregano. Let's put that in there like that. And our sauce is starting to heat up. Starting to bubble just a little bit. So next we're going to add our... Okay, so next we're going to add a little bit of this Dijon mustard. This Grey Poupon. Got a little bit of that out of there. Add that to the pot. And we have to keep stirring here because we don't want to burn anything. We don't want our sauce to start sticking. You know how honey can be. All right, so this is going and I want to add a little spice to this as well. So we have this chili garlic sauce here. And add a little bit of that. Get a little kick in there, maybe a little bit more. Spice up the chicken a bit. Okay, so our sauce is ready. What we're gonna do next, we're gonna pour some of this over the chicken and let it set for a couple of hours, and then we're gonna take it to the oven. Okay, so here's our finished sauce. It has an orangey looking color to it. We're gonna give it a taste. See what it tastes like here. It has the tanginess of the mustard. It has a little bit of spice. Didn't get too much kick from that chili paste. So you may want to add some more chilies to yours if you like your wings or your chicken spicy. You might want to add a little more chili. I didn't add any salt because we salted the chicken, and mustard is usually has a pretty high salt content. But if you believe you need more salt, please go ahead and add some. Okay, so we have our chicken here, which has been in the oven for about 90 minutes now, maybe a little bit longer. It's been sitting in the honey mustard glaze for that time. So now our next step is to get it in the pan, and we're gonna roast it in the oven. And I guess you could call this pan roasted chicken, or you could call it just baked chicken. But the thing is, we're using a pan here, but you can use your baking pan or your casserole dish, whatever you may have handy that you can use to bake this chicken off in the oven. So we're going to put all four pieces in here like this here. Now we're going to put it in a 385 degree oven. It's probably going to cook for about 35 minutes. After 15 minutes, we're going to glaze it because I do have some of the glaze left over. And we're going to glaze it about 15 minutes in, and then we'll check it again after 25 or 30 minutes. We may glaze it one more time, but we'll see. So we're going to the oven now. Here we go. Okay. Chicken has been in the oven about 12, 13 minutes. And what we're gonna do is, I have some of the glaze here that we mixed up earlier. I'm gonna glaze this chicken again. And the reason why I let it cook some is because I don't want to contaminate my sauce here with any raw chicken. So we know after 12, 13 minutes, the outside of the chicken is no longer raw. So now we can sauce it up. We're gonna put it back in the oven, set the timer for 10 minutes, and then check it again. Here we go. Okay, chicken went back in the oven for 10 more minutes. It's getting there. The glaze is starting to semi-brown up some. This is an easy meal to prepare. I mean, this is what I call a weeknight meal. I mean, a busy working person can prepare this meal, get it on the table for the rest of the family without too much fuss during the weekday. So I just glazed the chicken again. We're going to put it back in the oven for another 10 minutes. It should be done by then. And we're going to see about getting it plated up. Okay, here is our chicken. It's been in the oven for about 35 minutes now. We glazed it twice. So it has a nice glaze on it. It's a little brown. I mean, you could leave yours in the oven to get it more brown if that's what you prefer. But I think we got a nice chicken dish here. We have four pieces. This would go good for a family of three or four. Everybody get a piece of chicken, and you could pair this with some rice, some vegetables, potatoes, bread, even a salad. So I think we got a nice weeknight meal. What I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna get this chicken on a plate, and then we'll show you what it looks like. Here we have it, our honey mustard, pan roasted, chicken thighs, sprinkle a little parsley on them here. And like I said, this is a good dish for a weeknight. It's not too fancy. We're just getting dinner on the table tonight. So this looks good. So it's an easy recipe. I'm going to put all of the ingredients and comments in the section below. Please try it. Hope you and your family enjoy it. I want to thank you for viewing my videos and have a good day.